filled with so much expectation being here. And I feel very honored to be invited to be here. Then I am prepared, you know, my mind, my spirit is prepared to take in much more than I've taken in before.
We've been waiting for this day, you know. Pastor Kunle is just an awesome guy, and it's been a blessing not only to God but to humanity. So I think he deserves all the support that he's getting today.
I'm good, good. Get to see handsome people on the red carpet or the green carpet.
In his presence, PKA, 30 years in ministry. How do you feel about that?
I feel great. One of the reasons I feel this great is maybe because I've known him from early days, and all the corrections he made then, you know, that I would get angry at, I'm seeing the results of them now in my own life. I mean, early days he would correct us and I would get so upset. You know, but now, years later, I realize that if you are not taking heed to some of those words, you probably are burnt out already by now. So I'm here to celebrate God, celebrate freshness, and to receive a newness, you know, of God through him. So.
Pastor Kunle is somebody we respect a lot that carries the presence, and he has put this program together and tagged it in his presence. So I am expectant so much to be filled, to be helped, you know, in different ways, looking at people, listening to his story, seeing him perform, different things. So I'm full of expectation tonight.
Wow. I could say he's an inspiration. That's why I'm here.
We know that God has been at the center of it all. But is there anything that we need to know that we don't already know? Are there secrets that, you know, is there a particular formula that people need to know and apply? How have you done it?
Praise the Lord. I want to thank God once more, and thank God for my children that God has given to me. And he said I'm not sweet. He's not telling you the truth. You could remember, there was a day I said, don't do this. You remember? I beat him once.
Only once.
Ah, I said that. And he said, daddy will never beat me again. And he kept to it. I beat him once because I was trained in the barracks. And people that trained me, people call it wickedness. I can't beat people. If I beat you, they use rod. The death is the truth. Even services of people, have witnesses in. They use iron rod. They use kuboko. What did I do? If I go to another man's church, that's it. And I'll be beaten. So, but I told him, don't come home all alone from school. The first time he did it, the second time I said, don't try it again. He taught the father that loves him, that carries him all the time. When he did it, did that again, I brought out the belt with iron and I beat him. And he said, I will not allow daddy to beat me again. And he came to his word. He had been beaten. Even while he was in London studying, he had been very good.
Former governors of the Cross River State and Abia State, the descendant of Pastor Kunle Ajayi, chairman of the CAN, my father's in the Lord and my mother's in the Lord, distinguished guests, and all the people of them. I'm so excited to be here this evening because this is a different concert that I'm actually witnessing in the last 30 months that I've been in the seat of power. What you always come to a hotel to do is to witness concerts that really concern those artists and entertainers that really don't have a complete plan. They will pay money to do all that to enjoy it. We are celebrating a genius. We are here this evening to celebrate one of our own. Some operates our spirit with music and draws us closer to God in worship. Pastor Kunle Ajayi. I'm excited to be here because many times we celebrate foreign artists and we neglect our own homegrown stars. Pastor Kunle Ajayi is one of our own, a proud product of the Lagos State College of Education, now the Adeniran Olusoye College of Education. Whether we like it or not, Pastor Kunle Ajayi is a star. God has made him a star. 30 years on stage is an outstanding achievement and worthy of celebration. That's what we're gathered here to celebrate you, PK. Kunle Ajayi is a role model to all Nigerian youths and aspiring musicians. As you can see, even from the combination of whatever it is that he has put up so far recently, you'll see that he's not an entertainer. He's a talented musician and he's up like we've seen also, is multi-talented and is willing to actually give back to humanity through all the things that he has actually done. He should be a source of hope and inspiration to all of us, not just through his music, but again, by his life testimonies. Just as we have just been told this evening, many of us did not know that as a young child, he had health challenges. With his lungs, he had problems breathing and also struggled with any physical exertion, but God healed him miraculously. And then he decided dedicates his life to blowing the sax for God. As it inspires us to praise and worship God with music, Kunle has also dedicated himself to raise a new generation of musicians with his PK Music Academy. So what's happening here is that we're going beyond music, and here we're trying to support somebody that is trying to establish a music academy so that these younger ones can start to tap their talent, and then we can make use of that to discover other people. This academy will take more of our youths off the streets and help them discover their God-given talents. These are the kinds of initiatives that we must all embrace and support. Our administration will continue to support music, arts and culture, because it is a veritable instrument to address youth unemployment and actually also grow the economy of the state. On my part, and on behalf of the government, we will support the PKA Music Academy. We look forward to this academy raising better talents and then contribute positively to the growth of our music and entertainment industry. As we celebrate Pastor Kunle Ajayi today, I wish him many more precious years singing for the Lord and his people. So as part of that inspiration, Lagos State Government will support this PKA Music Academy and will also ensure that it leads to attest to the testimony of bringing out greater talents from our younger ones and also to the glory of God. God bless you.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Executive Governor of Lagos State, Governor Akinwunmi Akpabio, let's appreciate him for that wonderful speech.
His focus, his stern, is outstanding. Stays with what he believes in. Stays with it. If he believes you're the one, you're the one, no matter what anybody says. If he believes you're wrong, until you get it right, you're wrong. You know, so he's a very firm man, very stern man, very tough man, like I said, talking to the other media people. But he's a good man, great heart, and we love him so. I desire his size, but...
Well, I think it's focus, consistency, and discovering your purpose and fulfilling it in line with what God has in store for you. So it's just, he's a mentor to many, many people, and he's been very consistent.
Lord that has started a good thing in their lives, he completes it with his blessing and abundant grace, overflowing grace, powerful grace. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Heavenly Father, we thank you. We give you praise today. We can never, never thank you enough. It can only be you, God, for what we have known and what we have seen today. And we thank you that you are the Alpha and the Omega. Whatever you start, you will surely, see it through to the end. And so, Father Almighty, today, we are thanking you for the beginning. We thank you for those who started with him. We thank you for the faithful ones, while they were still young and they were moving around, and you kept them by the power of your hand. Today, you have nurtured all of them to this stage. And so, Father, we want to say thank you. Thank you for all those albums we have listened to. We thank you for the voice that you have not allowed to cease. We thank you for the miracles that he has experienced in life, which is now showing his gratitude to you by singing unto you and by blowing for you. We thank you for the entire family, most especially for the wife who have been on the enduring side, when the husband will go for BG for almost 3 times a week, when he will raise up in the night and the husband will be blowing trumpets while everybody should be sleeping, and is disturbing the old house. He wants to say thank you for these children that grew and took after their father. We want to say thank you. For all those who raise his hands up, Jehovah, we can never thank you enough for them. We know as the time of the harvest of Pastor Kunle and the family has come, so also their own time of harvest shall come in Jesus' name. We place them in your hand, in your mighty hand, that the mercy of God has endured forever. And the grace of the Almighty God that passes all understanding will rest upon you, will sustain you to the end. This is just a beginning of greater things. So you shall give. You shall give to declare more of the glory of the Almighty God. In the morning, in the night, in the evening time, the Lord will stand by you.
Amen.
This family will glorify God forever.
Amen.
Anything that is evil, we resist, we reject, and we repent. In the mighty name of Jesus,
amen,
this will not be your portion.
Amen.
And all the people that are here tonight, who love you and love what you are doing and care, I pray your returns, the Lord Almighty will shower his love over all of them in the name of Jesus. As for the project of the Music Academy, you commit it to the hand of the Almighty God. All those who have promised to bring anything, most especially money, for this project to take off, we pray, Lord, those people will never lack anything.
Yeah.
Even as they are thinking in their hearts to move on to, in whichever area they want to move on in their lives, I pray God will supply their needs.
Yeah.
And we pray that this project will not lack any form of finance.
Yeah.
It shall be done.
Yeah.
And it will glorify the name of God. Father, we give you praise tonight. We can never thank you enough. We have been so awesome in this place. Without exalted forever. And our prayer is that all of us we will never lack grace and mercy of God. To the end of our days. And where we shall sing forever, hallelujah, chorus. Please, Lord, count us worthy. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
I thank God and I'm grateful to God. I'm very happy and I give glory to God.
All right, now, sir, 30 years in ministry, what are the lessons you think the younger generation can learn from you?
They should grow up. They should not grow up. Okay. When you grow up, you have roots. When you grow up, it comes down.
All right, sir. Sir, 30 years from now, what are we expecting from you after today?
Special anointing, greater heights. You know, I'm only came 30 in the ministry ahead, so there's still more. God told me he has not started. And it was confirmed by my daddy in the law. He said, I haven't started anything.
Thank you very much.